Yeah, go ahead, load it again. Everett, have you heard of Rob's Coke Zero spot?
No.
Say it again.
You have to start on me already?
Yeah.
How bad can it be?
All right.
Hey, what's up? It's Rob Riddlemoser from the Russ Martin Show. Hear that? That's what they call commercial copy. It's the script that the fine folks over at Coca-Cola gave me so that I could tell you about Coca-Cola Zero. I guess they forgot that this past summer when they delivered the Coca-Cola Zero to me.
I guess they forgot. I'm going to fail.
What's he doing?
He's over the top. I wonder if he wrote his own copy or they gave it to him.
That's a good question. It sounds like the way he talks.
He didn't talk like that.
I don't mean the energy level, but I mean just it sounds like something he'd write.
Oh.
But delivered by Carnival Barker.
Yes.
Not quite as slow.
No.
Hey, what's up? It's Rob Riddlemoser from the Russ Martin Show. Hear that? That's what they call commercial copy. It's the script that the fine folks over at Coca-Cola gave me so that I could tell you about Coca-Cola Zero. I guess they forgot that this past summer, when they delivered the Coca-Cola Zero to me,
being the asses that they are,
I had to go from store to store to store to find more because there were people that tried Coke Zero and it changed their life just like it changed mine. I've ditched the coffee. It's all Coke Zero for me. And you know what? I can drink as many as I want because I don't have to worry about sugar or calories. And Coke Zero tastes just like Coke. Don't take my word for it, people. Go try it for yourself. On second thought, I've got to be selfish about some things, don't I? It's about time someone made a great tasting soda with no calories. I don't need commercial copy. I just need more Coke Zero. Bring me some Coke Zero.
Here you are. I was okay till the...
Bring me!
Yeah.
And it'd be okay if you didn't know it was Rob.
You know, well, no, I mean... No, it wouldn't.
It's classic.
All his other spots aren't like that, are they?
No, I just think they probably told him... Sometimes I write in the copy, high energy.
Oh, no.
Yeah,
oh,
yeah, no. Yeah.
No, you don't tell it to somebody on roids.
No.
Not roids, ephedra, and caffeine. Hold on a second. Hi, Ben.
Hey, what's going on? Yeah, I'm over at the Hooters in McKinney.
Yeah?
And Mr. Magoo or whatever from 92.5 is doing a live promo.
Really?
Oh, no.
Yeah.
Hold on. What, Dan?
Those good old bringing the weekend parties, man.
Is that what it is?
That's what it is.
Oh. Where is it again?
Hooters in McKinney, off of 75 and 380.
So he's going to be there till 7?
He's going to be here till 7.
He has to stay.
Yeah, he can't get away from this.
There's no doors. There's no windows.
Thanks, Ben.
You bet.
All right, call me later.
All right, man.
I don't even have to say anything.
No, you don't.
Because you know these weasels that listen, they'll just do it.
Yeah.
They'll show up in fish outfits smoking a cigar.
Yeah, it's on.
Yeah.
Damn.
Maybe that's how he's going to increase his ratings. He's going to be killed in appearance.
Yeah, but that's something good to say. Thank you. Don't say that again.
Okay.
Do these things not flash on you when you say them?
What do you mean?
Killed in appearance.
Well, I'm obviously not serious.
I understand, but that doesn't... Nobody says anything to you ahead of time.
Sorry, no.
All right.
Don't.
Hey, what's up? It's Rob Riddlemoser from the Russ Martin Show. Hear that? That's what they call commercial copy. It's the script that the fine folks over at Coca-Cola gave me so
what?
That I could tell you.
What?
I've already taken the liberty of putting this in the bottom mini disc player. It is, it's Rob's new spot for Coca-Cola Zero.
Here. It's like a rotator.
It's on the bottom mini disc player. There you go.
Hey, what's up? It's Rob Riddlemoser from the Russ Martin Show. Walking on the moon, inventing the internet.
All right.
Yes.
Is he going to equate all of those with the invention of Coke Zero?
I think that's where we're going.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hey, what's up? It's Rob Riddlemoser from the Russ Martin Show. Walking on the moon, inventing the internet. You laugh, but I put this right up there, people. A drink that tastes exactly like regular Coke, but it has no calories. It's Coke Zero. I'm hooked. I'm hooked. I'm cuckoo for Coke Zero.
He did not.
This is not real.
Well, it is.
Hi, Rob. Hi, cuckoo.
What did he just bring in?
Your gifts.
You got some stuff.
What'd I get?
All right.
Who's this from?
This is from Crown Royal. There's a bottle of Reserve.
How come I got this?
Folks from Crown Royal just dropped it off. I guess they hear you, and this is a gift set with two beautiful.
It's a nice box. I didn't realize the Crown Reserve came in a whatever you call this.
Looks
hand carved,
wooden box, beautiful.
Yeah.
What else I get?
And this is a gift set with two beautiful glasses, and read the label, the Crown bottle.
Very nice, Crown Royal, Russ Martin, King of Dallas Radio.
This reminds me of my dad in the old days. I was a member of the Crown Royal Society.
The what?
Crown Royal Society.
What is that?
It's basically you buy the Crown Royal, they get you on the list somehow.
You get an island.
And every
come live with us.
Every year they send you. Every year they send you a gift. And one year it was a
Ford truck.
No, it was just the labels, like the personalized labels that have your name on it.
They don't have anything that comes with a cork.
Do not.
What is this? Select looks like maybe it does. No. See, that didn't carry the magic. Club?
Absolutely.
What?
Nothing.
See, when you drink the Jack, I have no, because I don't, they just never had a flavor for that, but I used to have a real taste for
it. Yeah, this is smooth. Damn, it's smooth. That's like butter smooth.
Don't. I used to have three-legged monkeys. No, it's a. Why do I say these things?
I don't know, but I can't wait to hear the end of the story. Just, what did you do to the three-legged monkeys? How'd they get that way?
A drink.
Did this have anything to do with that saw?
No.
All right, go ahead.
It's just a drink, but it's chilled Crown, shot of Crown, chilled, and it's got something else in it. I don't know what it is, but it's called the three-legged monkey.
Do you know what it is, Clo?
Mm-hmm.
What?
It's just that and, okay, I'm sorry. I forget what it was. Oh, it's just a chilled shot with different things. It's kind of like a Tawaka lemon drop, very similar to that, but it's called the three-legged monkey. It's got Crown and some other stuff.
Drink that, the Big Apple. Oh, man.
Let me have that again, Clo.
I'll miss you all.
Hey, Everett, I know you don't drink. Do you want a sip?
I'll take a sniff of it.
Okay.
Oh, don't let me sniff it.
Now, can you not drink?
Or no, I can. I just choose not to.
Okay.
But I would like to smell it.
But you're never alcoholic. You just decided.
Yeah, I just had enough.
Okay. Does that have anything to do with your ileum or anything?
Yeah, a little bit.
Okay. Yeah, you should smell that.
Wow, JP.
Don't.
That is cruel.
Wow, you're not over here smelling delicious whiskey.
Dan, you're coming here smelling whiskey.
Can I smell it?
Huh?
Can I smell it?
I don't think it's good for an alcoholic.
Just smell it?
I don't think that's safe. It's like somebody on a diet. You don't let them smell a cow. You don't. Who wants to smell the taters?
All right. Keep on running.
All right, Everett.
That'll bring back a lot of memories.
Stop Bogarting. Got Dan to smell the whiskey?
Well, he can drink it.
That's nice.
Mm.
It's reserved, too.
It's like heaven in a bottle.
You guys are cool.
Yeah. Why don't you put some heaven in your tummy?
Yeah. One with the Lord now.
Yeah. What are you looking at, John?
Somebody sent me an IM. It's Crown, and Jaeger. Chilled. That's what three.
What do you mean somebody sent you an IM? You got to know where it's coming from.
Joy.
Oh.
I don't even think I get bitter beer face when drinking that.
Some of the best whiskey I've ever smelled.
All right. Mm-hmm. Let me at least smell it. Mm-hmm. Please.
Mm-hmm. I don't think that's...
I'm not going to drink it.
I don't think it's prudent.
Yeah.
I think it's rude on my part.
Well, it's rude is what you're doing. No. Passing around not letting me smell it.
No, it's far too delicious.
You kind of go way back.
It's like it's silk.
I used to have a collection of those bags that they come in. I mean, 50 of them.
What'd you make out of it? Hot air balloon?
No. Actually, a friend of mine turned them into a golf club covers.
For the carts?
No. Just the clubs. Okie dokie.
Just let me smell it.
Just let me smell it.
Let me let you smell. Hang on. Let me turn it over and you smell the cap. Just so you don't get wiggy and start drinking.
I'm not wiggy. On this farm.
I'm thinking of you.
I know. I could pull into the Seagulls any day and buy it if I wanted to. I'm not going to drink it.
No, the cat doesn't smell as good.
Let me smell the bottle.
I know why they call it Crown. It's majestic.
Yeah, it is. I know. Oh, Lord, do I know.
All right, here.
Thank you. Oh, yeah. God, yeah. Have a moment.
All right, everybody out.
No. Take it back. Oh, man. Bring it back memories.
Mm. Call you another?
Absolutely.
Bring back memories before with the police brought me home. You think I'm kidding?
They let you drink in the back of the car?
I got to sit in the front seat.
Really?
I was walking out of the Big Apple and police officer, who I happen to know, stopped me. He goes, where are you going? I went, home.
I go to the house. What's you?
He goes, no, you're not. Went, oh, man. He goes, get in the car. I went, front or back? He goes, get in the front. And I grabbed his PA and went, bad boys, bad boys. Swear to God, I did.
Just get in the car and don't make any freaking noise. I'm going to take you home. And nobody, if you keep your mouth shut, nobody will know what's going on.
I'm so embarrassing you.
All right.
Sorry.
Nice gift set.
It's beautiful. Joy actually made me. I used to drink Crown so much. She made me a quilt that's purple, mm-hmm. Purple, and it's a quilt of the bags sewn into the quilt. I still have it.
I never knew you drank Crown that much.
Oh, before I switched over to vodka, it was all Crown. I used to walk into the Big Apple and it was double Crown diet before I got in the door.
Why don't you switch?
Vodka don't stink.
Yeah.
You don't reek.
It's a lot easier to walk around in public with vodka on your breath.
Yeah, that's exactly it.
Were you doing that a lot?
Which one?
Walking around drinking.
Stinking.
Oh, sure.
Well, we have all the mixins for a party if Coke Zero will show up.
Oh, that sounds good. Mm. Don't.
All right, let me listen to the rest of this.
inventing the internet. You laugh, but I put this right up there, people. A drink that tastes exactly like regular Coke, but it has no calories. It's Coke Zero. I'm hooked. I'm hooked. I'm cuckoo for Coke Zero. Woo!
Is this real?
Yeah, that's a. That's
or
a,
you cut it just to be obnoxious?
No, it's a rotator spot. They updated the copy, so every time they rotate, it's not the same spot. I don't know that they told him to go this far.
It's Coke Zero. I'm hooked. I'm hooked. I'm cuckoo for Coke Zero. Woo-hoo! Coke Zero. I always drink a soda in the afternoon for that extra boost. Now I can drink this stuff all day. It's Coke Zero. Hey, you know, stuff like this, it's so good, but I have such a hard time tracking it down because you people are swiping it off the shelves like crazy. Leave my Coke Zero alone. Imagine if you could get a zero pizza. No calories, no carbs. You wouldn't believe it, right? Well, you've got to try this stuff. You know, before I would pour my diet soap.
I'm not kidding. I'm seriously getting dizzy. Hold on. Hi, Jason.
Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Just about to pull in the McKinney Hooters over here and want to see if you wanted any, like a catfish platter or maybe a pack of cigarettes. I'm over to the good.
Yes, please.
Yes, please.
Break the filters off the cigarettes.
Anything else?
No, that'd be all right for now.
Thanks, Bob.
All right, thank you. It's just the fact that he knows that there's some of our people there. That even if it's just one, but he doesn't know. Which
all it
one.
Takes is one to make you think that the place is full.
Exactly.
You completely lose concentration on what you're doing.
Put in a glass. I didn't want to look like a chick. Now I can hold the bottle with pride. It's
all right, hold on.
Well, you've got to try this stuff. You know, before I would pour my diet soda in a glass, I didn't want to look like a chick. Now I can hold the bottle with pride. It's my Coke Zero. Coke Zero, that's the only thing I need. I've ditched the coffee and it's all Coke Zero for me. It has the caffeine I want and need to keep going and going and going. Tastes great with Jack, too.
No, that's not.
That's not.
That's not right.
That's not real. All right. Stand corrected.
It tastes great with Jack.
Yeah, you want me to show you?
Yeah, I think they can put stuff like that. Well, I guess they can.
Well, they can co-op.
What?
Well, he's already ripped off, you know, three or four other companies. Why not throw in Jack Daniels?
What do you mean?
Well, he's got a couple of slogans. The cuckoo part. I don't know how copyright works, but...
I don't think Cocoa Puffs is coming after him.
I wouldn't think so, but...
I wonder if the fact that he doesn't actually specify Jack Daniels makes a difference.
Possibly, yeah.
What? In the liquor stores, they have the big signs that says a very, very generic look, and it says Jack and Coke. And you'll see that there. It didn't say Jack Daniels, didn't say Coca-Cola. It says Jack and Coke.
This came from the ad agency?
Yeah, these are my copy points.
Let me see. Now I can drink Coke Zero and actually feel like a man. He's not making this up.
Jesus.
Makes a great Jack and Coke.
Well, maybe that's why they picked him, because they knew he was a little... Off the top. Emotional?
Does it say high energy on there?
No. It looks like it's written straight for him, though. No. I can drink a zero-calorie soda and actually feel like a man. Makes a great Jack and Coke. I've never really been into the taste of those girly diet drinks because I've never liked the taste of diet. If there are any Coke Zero spots today, mark them all off. Okay. They've gotten more than they paid for the year. Our station manager had Coke Zero brought into our break room last Monday. I grabbed one and couldn't believe it. I don't know if I've had this or not.
I don't believe I have.
I have. It's really good.
Yeah.
Awesome. Yeah. It tastes like regular Coke.
Mark off the Coke spots for the weekend. What was that?
That was close. Sneezing, oh, more or less.
You all right?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. You want a break here?
Please.
Okay. Who was that, Dan?
That is Cheryl from the band Defile.
What does she want?
She wants to ask if they can come up today.
Yeah. Let them please.
Now, who is this?
It's, let me ask. Hi, Cheryl.
Hi.
How are you?
Doing good.
How long has your band been together?
About 3 years.
How many people in the band?
Two right now, and we got a sit-in drummer.
All right. And both you, is it your sister?
Yes.
You and your sister both play just regular guitar?
She plays guitar. We're both vocals. And on times we can't have a drummer, we have a G-deck.
What is a G-deck?
A G-deck is a Fender amp that plays drums and bass.
If you came up today, how long would it take you to set up and then leave?
It'll take us like about 5 minutes to set up and 5 minutes to take down.
What's the shortest song that you guys do?
About 3 minutes.
Okay. Hold on a second.
Please. I gotta see this.
What's the story?
Some band that Rob found on, was it Group Dreamville? Yes. Yeah. Would you like to hear one of their tracks?
Yeah, I'd love to.
No, you won't.
Well, I'll feel left out if I don't.
No, you won't.
Please, may I hear one?
All right.
Yes, sir.
Is it here, Claude?
Yes, Tom.
All right.
This track is called What Do You Want? And I have to tell you that because if I don't, you'll never know it.
Oh, okay. Well, they have a nice looking CD cover.
Yes.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
No, you're not.
It's an intro, you know, we're coming to the meat of the song.
I understand that.
The hook's around the corner.
Closer than you think.
Meat and hooks coming.
What do you want, me? What do you want? I don't think so. What do you want, me? What do you want? I don't think so.
They have their own sound.
Mm-hmm. And they want to bring it up here.
Well,
Rob says they have their own very unique look also.
Well, and you know, it may well be that live they're better than in the studio.
Exactly what I said.
I mean, I have no reason to believe that, but
they recorded this in a hotel room.
Well, oh, did they?
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Yeah. Don't have the studios, so they recorded it where they live. That's what I was told.
And they live.
No.
Cheryl.
Yes.
You guys live in a hotel room?
Yes.
How long have you done that?
For 2 months.
Oh, what happened?
We used to live up in Denton.
What happened there?
We decided to move to Dallas because music scene was better.
Oh. Are you looking for an apartment or are you just going to stay there at the inn?
We're looking for an apartment.
Oh. Are you and your sister married?
Nope.
Are you dating?
Not at the moment.
Oh. Seems like you'd have all the guys you could handle if you've been in a rock band.
Groupies.
Yeah. You have a lot of groupies?
We got a few.
Mm. Where are you going to be? Hold on a second, Cheryl. Yes, Rob?
They don't like guys. They're into chicks.
I know. I'm not big on them either. Where will you guys be performing next?
Battle of the Bands, Club Clearview.
Oh, that's right. Sunday?
Sunday night.
Sunday night.
And the thing is, that one last statement is untrue.
What one last statement?
That I heard that someone said.
What Rob said.
Oh, that you don't like guys?
Yep, that's totally false.
Oh. Well, that's good to know.
Yeah.
So I got a chance.
Yeah.
All right.
I dated a guy up in Denton.
How'd that go?
Well, I quit dating him. He kicked us out of the studio.
Oh. Was he a producer?
No. He knew the producer.
Oh, okay. What time would you want to come up today?
Well, we figured it'll take 2 buses to get up there.
2 buses?
Yep.
Why buses? Oh, dark buses.
Dark buses.
Yeah.
I'm thinking tour.
I know.
Right.
Yes.
You. Maybe you should have named your band Dart.
Very nice.
Thanks.
Get their own bus. That's awesome.
All over the freaking town. What is it, sweetie?
Hey, Rob.
Rob's not.
I mean, not Rob.
Russ.
Russ.
Yeah.
You want to know who you sound like?
Okay.
People from South Park.
Which one?
All of them.
I sound like all of them?
No, all of you sound like all of them.
Oh. Nobody's ever said that.
We're a big fan of South Park.
Oh, so that's good.
Yeah, and also we used to live in Colorado for a while.
Oh. Well, why don't you come up today and maybe we'll kill Chloe?
Actually,
bastard.
Not They killed Kenny.
I know. We don't have a Kenny. We're gonna. We'll have to make do. I hope you understand.
Yeah, I couldn't say the last line because of PMRC.
I know. All right, hold on a second. Dan, take her off hold for a second, so she can't hear me.
Please. They put it in. Yeah.
I feel like I'm having to stop at the Waffle House.
Daddy, please.
Stucky's is closed.
Be gone, roll, Daddy.
They've got that What Do You Want song that I want to hear live.
It's I either want to hear that one.
What was the other one?
Dan, go ahead and tell him to come up. Tell him to shoot for around 6 o'clock. That way I'll be well on the way to Toastland.
Oh no.
Hold on. What is it, Rob?
I had something I needed you to do at 6 o'clock.
What is that?
I thought maybe you wouldn't mind doing a christening.
Fine. The band can play afterwards.
Thank you.
It'll be like an event.
Lucky baby.
Yeah.
Defile played at my christening.
What a coincidence. I got more teeth than they do.
Jesus. We haven't seen them. This is what Rob said.
So, close said. They're both covered with tattoos, yeah. And they're missing an inordinate amount of teethers.
Okay.
Were we going to ask everyone?
And where was it that Rob saw them?
Where was it, Clint?
Some bar off Greenville.
Okay. Oh. Why?
I was just curious.
You interested in seeing them at the Battle of the Bands? Well, you won't have to. They're coming up.
Yeah, they'll be here.
Turn up the living air.
No. No. They're not going to.
Yeah.
It won't.
It's, yeah.
It's going to be fine.
It
won't. I can't wait. I wish it was then now.
Rock band.
Yeah.
It's going to be great.
Rock out with your teeth out. I either want to hear the What Do You Want or number three, the Don't Bring It. See what you think of it.
Okay.
The only problem is, I'm walking around the hall singing that yesterday.
I know, it's a great hook.
Yeah, it's got a great musical hook.
Mm-hmm. Well, see, there you go. It's just the production values that have suffered because they recorded at the end.
With a pillow. Thanks. All right, here's Don't Bring It. This one has harmony.
Okay.
And they both sing. It's going to be great.
Yeah.
I look forward to it.
No.
Don't do it. Don't say it. Just see me the headline. Don't bring it. Don't say it.
Put your headphones back on.
No. He's taking like one off. He's thinking his headphones are out of...
Oh. Yeah. Something went awry.
Yeah.
You're like looking at him.
Yeah. I'm not sure. I think one of my ears shifted.
Huh? I don't care what you do. I don't even want to know. You can do what.
I don't say this to be funny, but if it weren't for the song, it wouldn't be bad.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah?
I mean, the production and the vocals. And the vocals. Because it's got a nice hook, and it sounds like the lyrics are okay.
Yeah. Yeah, I think it just got lost in the mix.
Everyone, just don't bring it to me. Don't bring it, don't say it. Just leave me the hell alone. Don't bring it, don't say it. Just leave me the hell alone.
What's a hem-along?
The what?
Something about a hem-along. Don't bring it. Is that what it's called?
I guess. You asking me about their music?
Yeah.
No.
Well, I look forward to seeing them live.
All right.
Me too.
When this happens, you guys remember.
Okay. I'm excited.
Big rock show.
Okay.
After a christening.
Wow.
Yeah.
Maybe we'll do it during the christening.
No.
And they can spike the baby.
No. No. No, not me. No.
Not enough people to do crowd surfing.
No.
Spike the baby. Like you said before, spike the baby. Send it straight to heaven.
Yeah.
Perfect time?
Yeah, it's perfect christened.
Yeah, just got christened. Slam the baby. All right.
We'll God is waiting.
God's catchers, man. Slam the baby.
We'll be back to the Russ Martin Show. A number one radio show. And a spot on his ass. Reserved for your lips if you don't like it. Turn it up. Now, back to the Russ Martin Show.
Somebody what?
Sent an email that said, on Channel 5, a chase just ended and the cop is trapped inside the car.
Which setup there is on Channel... You know what? If they weren't all rolling, I could figure out which one was on Channel 5. Yeah. I thought they fixed these sets.
They came in and tried. They did. They moved the antenna, but apparently not to the right place. Not the reception zone.
Chloe, you know which one's Channel 5? Let me just watch for a minute. That one over on the far right's 11. Yeah. So that's got to be 8. That's got to be 5, right?
That may be out of order again.
You know what? Take them out. I'm tired of dicking around with it.
It can't be this difficult.
Yeah, it can. Because it's been 2 years we've been in this building, and it's been that way since we got here. That, the squeaky fours, and everything else that I bitch about on a daily basis that people got to suffer through, for some reason we can't get television signals in here, and it's been that way since July of 2002.
You're right.
Fox 4's left.
Oh, that's Channel 4?
On the left, yeah. So the middle one's either 5 or 8.
Hang on. Let me change them all. What do I get now? 2, 5. All right, there's 5, but it's commercial. All right, watch it and see what comes up. I don't care if they fix them or not. I'm not talking to Gavin anyway, so you guys can just unhook them. That's another issue.
I'm not talking to him.
What happened?
Did I just say I don't want to talk about
it? I guess.
Did I get that far?
No.
Mm-mm. Oh.
You just said you weren't talking to him.
Oh, okay. It's just another bitch session.
Okay. But you don't want to discuss it.
Mm-mm.
Okay.
Corporate weasel.
I knew it. What'd he do?
It's just, it's an issue with me and sales. And I said, I'm not doing something, and he's siding with them. And that's right. There's a longer story that goes along with it.
Yeah.
But if I get into it, then it's going to get too confusing. That's what it all boils down to.
Okay.
They screwed
something over.
They screwed something around and ended up costing the foundation money. And that's not, that don't happen.
No.
episode said, well, the station does a lot of the stuff for the foundation, okay? Well, this time it cost. And now I ain't helping you guys out.
You can do whatever you want. Leave your contracts written that way.
Mm-hmm.
And even if it wasn't, you can do whatever you want.
And it was emails back and forth today. I went, you know, finally I gotta knock this off. I gotta read the paper or watch something or go tan. I gotta do something. I can't email with you back and forth all day. If you figure out a way to get me that cash that we lost for the foundation, or I ain't doing nothing.
Fair.
I'm tired of this toe-to-toe with sales back and forth. He tried to stop me in the hall. I went,
I'm gonna discuss it.
I've already told him.
Well, they're pressuring him. He's in the middle. They're pressuring him. They're coming to him going, hey, you're the liaison. Get in here and talk to him.
No, he's gonna pressure. And here's the problem is, until there's a penalty, it's just like dealing with a little freaking kid. Until there's a penalty, nobody's going to pay attention.
You're absolutely correct.
Because what happened was this whole issue with the foundation and the money happened several months ago.
Okay.
And I'm waiting for somebody to come to me and say, okay, we screwed up. Here's what we're going to try and do. Maybe we set up a quick fundraiser or we do something. We screwed up. We'll give it a shot. Our fault. I've been waiting for that. Nothing happened.
You can't get a TV signal in here. You really think they're going to fix something in sales? They got TV signals under the bridge.
In prisons.
Yeah.
They have perfect signals.
Yeah, they get good signals in prison.
Death row.
I guess I gotta pop somebody.
No. Oh, we're gonna kill Chloe later.
Oh, that's right. So until something happens, it's just like dealing with a child. Until there's a penalty, they're gonna keep doing it.
You're right.
I finally told, here was the way it ended with Gavin. I went, they thought if they just ignored this, it'd go away.
Basically.
Well, guess what?
It didn't.
It's not.
Well, with you, sometimes if you ignore things long enough, you will forget them.
Not for the foundation. Not for the you foundation. Don't dick around that. Right. Yeah, if it was, if you screwed me out of $2,500,
if you'd giggle.
If you screw me out of some cash, fine. I'll write it off and I'll try and scrape by. But if you do it to the foundation, I'm gonna sit on that.
I know you are. They should know that by now.
In Gavin's defense, he offered to come up with the money on his own just to smooth all this out. I went, that's not going to fix the problem. If I wanted that, I'd stick the money in myself, and I'd be done with it.
That's not the issue. The issue is they didn't do something or they screwed something up.
Principle.
Yeah.
And they'll do it again.
Just like with ad copy that's supposed to be in here every Monday.
Right.
I said, you know what? I do all these endorsements. I want new copy every Monday. Fair. So the copy sounds fresh. It's good for me. It's good for the client. It's good for you, the salesperson.
Absolutely.
They weren't doing it. I stopped reading them. And now what happens? It comes in Friday before.
I bet you get a copy.
So you have to do something like that. Otherwise, they blow it off and it'll just sit there.
It's time out of their schedule they don't want to give. Because there's no direct reflection to their paycheck.
Well, you would think somebody would stop and say, hey, you know, it's kind of cool that a talent wants to sit there and update copy. He don't have to. He could read the same crap for
over and over and over
for months. I appreciate the fact that he wants to do that.
You would think from a sales perspective that would look like you're interactive.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-mm. Means extra work. Pisses them off.
We have luncheons.
Mm-hmm. I can't do that. Okay. I got other things I got to screw up. I can't type that stuff for you. Mm-mm. Pissing me off. So, until that gets resolved, I ain't talking to Weasel.
We're not talking to him at all. Are we not allowed to talk to him, or just you?
You do what you want. I've given up on having some form of loyalty around this place.
I'm just total loyalty. I'm asking. If you don't want us to talk to him, I won't talk to him.
What happened last time I said don't talk to him?
I saw him in the hall, and I can't ignore him.
Okay. Well, then obviously you can't do it. Why do you even ask?
I will. I just forgot I slept. I was weak.
You forgot to ignore it.
Do you hear the words? I forgot to ignore my boss. Well, on paper.
I understand. When they get that handled, then I'll be back to being the team player.
You forgot to say that.
That I've always strived to be.
That I believe.
Thank you. I'm the Tyrell Owens of the station.
Yes, you are.
All right, you want to do news?
Yeah, sure. Is that the cup thing on five?
Oh, hang on.
If you read the recent numbers...
The trooper is negotiating this small turn here, lost control of his vehicle, and he careened off of the road and struck a tree. Struck that tree very, very hard. In fact, it ripped the car open. The tree is virtually wrapped. The car is virtually wrapped around the tree. Now, when we arrived...
I can't read the picture. Where is that?
Denton County.
Frantically to free him from that vehicle. There was a number of... rescue personnel on top of the car, around the car with the jaws of life, trying to extricate him from the car. They were successful in doing that just a few moments ago, and the trooper has been removed from the vehicle. His condition is not known, but we understand that he is responsive, and when we saw him being loaded into the ambulance, in fact, you see that there now, they were working on him. They put, they had an IV in him.
You have a tree split a car in half, and you make it through that.
And doing okay.
It's unbelievable.
As far as we could tell from up here, but he is en route to the hospital now. They are still on the scene. Something happened here after the state trooper was removed from the vehicle and loaded into the care flight helicopter. Someone else became over. They were either overcome from exertion. We're not sure exactly what happened, but they were working on someone else on the ground here just a few moments ago. But this all happened just a little over an hour ago here on Highway 428, just on the west side of Aubrey. Back to you.
All right. Thanks, Ken. And we do have a great...
All right. Hold on. Hey, Rob. Check with the... who do we know up there? Denton County Sheriff's Department?
Yeah, we used to know Weldon Lucas.
He's not sheriff anymore.
I know.
Check up there and see if they know what's going on.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, weird.
What is it now?
On the left TV, that's Ed Young, my pastor.
Oh,
it's a church service.
Answer another story here. I mean, granted...
No.
So today, I thought we would sit that's back
Ed.
And relax...
Is that Ed?
And
what channel is that?
I don't know.
How to do this.
How can you tell it's Ed?
Because I know him. I know it's scrambled, but I know his voice. I saw him.
Very, very...
Those scrambled TV channels come in better than this.
Conversations
you're right.
And letters and emails
that's my
that
church.
I received over the years, some cliff notes.
It's a big place. It's huge. Now, it'll hold about 4,000 people per service times four.
Or betray any confidences, but we are going to know.
Not a chance in hell I can tell you what he looks like.
No, it's scrambled.
Cheat.
It looks like a 3D image and you don't got the glasses on it.
Very good description.
You're going to have an affair. You've got to convince yourself that it cannot happen.
All right, we'll watch that later. I'm still in a quandary since Jeopardy.
I got smoky. I'm sorry.
No, that's all right. I'm not going.
You would love it, but okay. I'm not trying to drag you.
What's different about his service than anybody else?
As you can see, you can watch
I
it.
Can't see anything.
It's just he speaks normal street talk, and he just speaks of the Bible, but in today's language. And he does a lot of visual presentations. This time, one time he had a tank on the stage.
Tank of what?
A tank, a full-size army tank.
Okay.
Talking about God's armor, that type of thing.
All right. What about God's armor?
Well, I mean, that was the series. It was for like 4 weeks in a row. It was a full-size tank.
Shoot out Jesus bullets?
Shoot out anything. No, he would come out of it at the beginning of the service. And
he'd come out of the tank. Uh-huh. How'd they get a tank on stage?
That I don't know. There was a huge back door. There was another time that, you know, the story about the eye of the camel and the whole thing, the rich man, brought a
what's
camel.
What's that story?
From the Bible? It's easier for...
You get a rich man into heaven than a camel through the eye of a needle?
Yeah, yeah, that's it. And he actually had a
fair
real...
Enough. Thank you.
I'm impressed. He had a real... yeah, actually a real camel. In fact, I was the cameraman.
They run it through the eye of a needle?
No. I was camel cam.
You what?
I was camel cam.
What were you in charge of? Shooting his toes?
No. No.
My church.
No, but he came up on stage, and I was the mobile camera that followed him from the back area where the camel was staying.
All right.
And he just brings a lot of...
So he likes a lot of props. Well, almost kind of like the Gallagher of televangelism.
He doesn't do magic? He doesn't do magic.
He squash melon?
No, he just, you know...
Juggles. Yeah.
When we talked about God throwing you a life raft. The stage was built up like the deck of a ship. Just things like that. He's just really very creative, very visual. As you see, this...
I can't see. Stop pointing at that.
I'm sorry. the television broadcast that you see here is the actual service, and that's what's also done on the screens. They have a, they have a switching room that's every bit as impressive as Channel 4 or 5.
Well, the technical aspect doesn't, I get nothing out of that. I'm asking about his message.
The message.
Couldn't care less about the TV broadcast, especially now.
The message is just very contemporary. He speaks street ease and to contemporary issues.
Do you go just to see if he's going to have a camel or a tank?
No.
Are you mad when he don't?
No.
I would be.
Yeah.
It's just very, it's very contemporary. Why do people go there? Like I said, they have
When's Elephant Day?
There's no specific elephant.
That would suck. You go and there's a wildebeest 1 week, and next week, nothing.
Yeah. Hey, look, they're going to baptize Valerie.
You should at least drive up and see the comet. It's amazing. The church is beautiful.
Where's the church?
Right across from Greg Bamnell's mall.
Oh, okay.
Up 121.
Was that especially tasty for you, Everett? Or are you thinking of something else?
I just got this vision of her being submerged in the water, spitting her out.
Oh, yeah. Turns into one of those, what is it when you get the
dry ice?
Just boils.
A what?
Whirlpool?
Yeah. Nice, I'll throw your laundry in. A lot of agitation going to waste.
Baptism and clean sheets all the same day. Oh my God.
We thought about flying over Hurricane Rita, dropping in the middle of it. Told her to spin backwards.
It's the antidote.
Yeah.
Drop her in a hurricane.
Don't forget, spin counterclockwise. Bring that bitch to a stop. Chloe locked the door just in case. I'm not kidding around. Because sometimes she just comes flying in. Thank you. Who's on the hotline?
Uh-oh.
Who?
Turn the lights.
Get the lights on. Who is it? Turn your mic on and tell me who it is.
It's Tom Reedy, the Denton County PIO.
Oh. Is he going to be able to tell me anything, or are they still in the stages of finding out?
I didn't get a whole lot of info. You were talking to me as well.
Sorry. Go ahead and find out, and then let me know afterwards. I didn't get it from the story, and I certainly couldn't get it from the pictures. If the trooper was chasing somebody and lost control, or he was responding to
something. It was a chase.
Okay. So what else does he have at church?
It's just a church service. I mean, you can, yeah, I know you can't
see
it.
Stop pointing at it. Chloe, turn it off.
You can hear him. But
all right. Hold on. Let me see what Dan's got.
Yeah, he can give you some information.
Okay. And it's Tom Reedy?
Yes, sir.
All right. Tom.
What are you doing?
I didn't do that. It flashed right before I picked it up.
I'll try and get it back.
All right. So
the church is just very contemporary. He just,
I got it.
Okay,
he speaks
all
in contemporary terms.
That's
but
all.
What is it I'm going to get out of that I just by, you know, being a stand-up guy? What is it that's going to change?
It's just like anything else. It's like
you understand what I mean?
No, absolutely.
Because if he's taking just common sense, don't F people around thinking, I got that.
Well, he just explains the Bible to you in layman's terms.
But that's the thrust of the Bible.
Sure.
Don't F people around.
That's basically
take care of other people and spread the gospel.
Okay. Yeah, you're right. You covered it.
Yeah. Obviously, that's not all of it. Yeah, you're not going to get people in to hear me say that, but what is it that I'm going to get out of him that
not a whole lot other than it's just it's like anything else, like getting a booster shot. You go in, you just get the message and it feels good.
Well, and too, I mean, there's a sense of community that arises when you're in a church setting like that and you're around
great
like-minded people who are
great
trying to do the same thing. And
possibly just a reminder.
A lot of hot chicks.
What do I care about that?
You don't.
I'm there to praise the God.
I know you are.
Well, what do you bring the hot chicks for?
Well, part of the thing about, you know.
Part of the what?
Allure. Of the group, yeah.
The magic?
If you're single. If you're
the
single,
scent?
If you're single. No.
Scent? Go ahead.
If you're a single person, it's a good place to meet like-minded people.
Women who are also living God's word.
Nobody's perfect, but yeah, trying to.
Sniffers.
Yeah.
No one's sniffing anything at church. What's the matter with you?
You are.
I'm not.
Going after your scent.
I don't sniff at church.
Why'd you bring it up?
I just said, I'm just mentioning there's a lot of hot women, and as well as good-looking guys.
They have
you're a single chick.
They have cloth seats there?
Yes.
I'm going.
God, you're not going with me again.
Eh?
No, you're not. I'll go.
Yeah, wood don't hold a smell. Cloth grabs it like a grabber.
You are... God. Mm.
You want a break?
Yes.
All right. Dan, what happened?
He had to hang up because he's having to set up media for a press conference, I believe. If he gave me some information, he told me to give it to you.
Yeah, what do you got?
At about 2:15, the state trooper, I think he's on one of the highways, he lit up a motorcycle going 130 miles per hour, coming over a hill, lost control of his vehicle, hit the tree, car catches fire. An Aubrey police officer later caught up to the motorcycle, arrested him, looked up, saw smoke a couple miles back, went back, saw the trooper's car.
So the car sat there for a while.
It was there for, they don't know what the time elapsed was from when he hit the tree, when the fire started.
Because normally you hear about something like that and you assume that the police car behind him saw it, stopped, and everything was being handled. Nobody was behind it.
It didn't appear so. From what he was telling me, it sounded almost like the trooper was in the chase initially by himself and an Aubrey officer connected to the highway further down the road is what it sounds like.
Okay.
So I don't think the Aubrey officer was directly behind him. I could be wrong. So the motorcycle guy was caught and arrested by Aubrey PD. 10 minutes, Aubrey Fire Department, after the car hit the tree, they were able to get the trooper out of the vehicle. Tom Reedy said it didn't appear that the trooper was burned in any way, but he was awake, he was conscious and breathing when he was care flighted to Parkland.
Okay. And that let us know anything else?
Yeah, if we need to call, we can. He's setting up a press conference, I believe.
Well. Okay, good enough. Thank you. All right, we'll be back.
We'll be back to the Russ Martin Show. McDonald's McRib sandwich might be going away for good? Visit McRib.com to find out what you can do. The number one afternoon show is found right here. The Russ Martin. This is the Russ Martin Show, featuring J.D. Ryan, Rob Riddlemoser, Dan O'Malley, Chloe Rayborn, Everett Newton, and Gail Lightfoot. Now, back to the Russ Martin Show.
Rob or Dan?
Rob.
He did? Oh, did he?
Yeah. He called up there to the Hooters in McKinney where Magoo is.
Hold a second. I'm surprised that Gary Hoey is not...
Bigger.
Yeah.
He's great.
Yeah. Why is that?
I just think it's the genre, the nature of the music that he plays doesn't have the sort of widespread appeal that...
Well, what about somebody like Joe Satriani?
Well, there again, I mean, you know, he had his time when he was very popular and he's still around, but I mean, what do you really hear about him anymore?
Yeah.
Not a whole lot.
I mean,
he's got a great body of work, but he's just not that commercially viable.
I'm not a big guitar freak, but I love this stuff.
Oh, yeah. His Christmas stuff is cool.
Yeah. Love all this stuff.
Hi, Trey.
Hello.
What are you doing?
Nothing.
Stay out of the sun today?
Obviously.
All right, hang on. All right, so Rob did what?
He calls the Hooters up in McKinney where Magoo is doing a broadcast.
Yeah?
Okay, so he says, I'm with the promotions department here at KZBS. It means it's very important that I get through to Magoo.
Okay, so he's telling that the chick answers.
Yeah, fine. All right. She goes, oh, Let me go get him if it's an emergency. There right. He is. So he waits and he waits and he waits. Magoo finally comes to the phone. And he goes, Magoo. I goes, yeah. He goes, I just heard you were out there on the Russ Martin show. I heard you were there at the Hooters. We're coming.
Yeah, that'll be enough to carry him to seven.
Yeah, an adrenaline pump.
Well, plus there are already listeners out there jacking with him, so that'll be enough for the next few hours.
Hooters should thank you.
What?
Hooters should thank you. You're going to get all that extra business.
Oh, yeah.
Sure.
Where is it again?
It's the Hooters in McKinney.
Do you know where it is, Paul?
No, that's
not. If you live up there, you know where it is.
It's got to be right off 75.
Didn't somebody say 380 earlier?
75 no. And 380.
That's where it is.
Yeah. Okay. All right. What are you going to do now?
I don't know.
What were we doing before the break?
Talking about some stuff.
Oh, I know. Everett said that the guy on the motorcycle running from the cop, okay. If the police officer dies, the guy on the motorcycle could get charged with murder.
First degree.
Really?
Under
he didn't do it.
Well, but under the, it's called the felony murder doctrine. It actually comes over from common law in England. It's in the Texas Penal Code. But basically what it says is that if you commit a felony, and during the commission of that felony...
So running from the cops is a felony?
Well, it is. Evading arrest is a felony if you're in a vehicle. It's a misdemeanor if you're on foot. But okay. Under those facts, I think you could charge him with first-degree murder.
Jeez.
If, you know, obviously we hope the officer doesn't doing well. But
you think a jury would buy that?
If
you're charged with something doesn't mean it's going to play out that way, because his defense could be... I was going too fast. I didn't know somebody was chasing me, or I didn't know he ran off the road because I was busy doing 130 miles an hour.
Right. Well, and that might be in the nature of the defense's case, but I think, you know, certainly in good faith, the prosecution could bring a case for first degree murder under the felony murder doctrine, because again, all that's really required is the commission of another felony, and during the commission of that felony, either, you know, even during the escape from it or what have you, if a person dies, then you can be charged with their murder. In fact, there is case law that. On point that says that there was a woman that was actually handcuffed in the back seat of a police car while they were chasing her boyfriend, and the two of them had been involved in a robbery, and the guy killed one of the police, and she was charged with his murder, even though she was handcuffed and in the back seat of a police car, because it was during the commission of the crime, and even though she was physically immobilized, the felony doctrine murder still applied, and she got life in prison.
Good.
For the murder.
Jesus. I'm okay with that.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm glad they caught that guy down the road for the motorcycle dude.
Well, and it's a good public policy because, you know, if you're engaging in conduct that could...
Well, everybody sees it. These guys on the motorcycles, I don't even have to say it.
No.
You've seen it.
Sure. Absolutely.
And they get on there and they think, you know what? If I can get away from him quick enough before somebody else gets in on the chase, I got a good chance of getting out of this.
Yeah, they can do 130 and nothing.
Yeah, it's a big problem. I mean, until a few years ago, I think it was maybe 99 that the law changed. Until then, evading was a misdemeanor whether you were on foot or in a car. But because of all of these types of problems, the law changed and now it's a felony in a vehicle.
Good. I thought it was I realize it's a state trooper, but most departments' policies now that they don't get involved in these high-speed chases anymore.
I think a trooper can do whatever he wants.
I think so. I think, a lot of the municipalities have said that they're not going to pursue people. But
unless they've done something like a murder or a bank robbery or something. If they're just speeding, sometimes they let them go.
I think so, you know, because they can always call ahead, too. It's a lot safer and probably as effective.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's always a joy to be on the tollway and you have one of those jackasses come up riding on the white line.
Mm-hmm. In and out.
My door's got these problems of slinging open.
No.
I nearly hit one night. They got real cute, and they slapped my door, and they went by.
What?
And it scared me, and there was one on each side.
I think that's a game with them of
slapping a door.
I've
never heard of that.
Yeah.
And it was the one on my right side, and then it startled me, and I swerved over, and I nearly clipped his buddy.
Too bad. He didn't.
That's funny, though.
I never heard of that game. That's a game now. You go by and see me slap the car and get away.
Yeah, I
know they can get away from us because the car can't accelerate.
Right.
For the one who would want to. chase down the tollway in and out of traffic trying to nail a motorcyclist. It sounds like a fun video game.
But. Yeah. Dan, what is line one?
It's a guy saying he heard of a story out of East Texas where same situation, police cruiser wrecked its vehicle, the officers were fine, but they tried suing the suspect for the damage to their car, and the police actually lost because of the juror or whatever. They said that the cop should have backed off, and it was their own fault.
I guess, you know, you could make an argument, I mean, of assumption of the risk, you know, because you've undertaken this sort of conduct, you can expect that maybe you'll be in the accident.
All right, well, then you go back and you address the jury and say, all right, this guy that they were chasing, what if he had just done something to you, yours,
yeah,
somebody you know? We cut him loose? We let him go? Because if they get the idea that they're always going to break loose during a high-speed chase, they're all going to do it.
Exactly. Sure. That's when they passed, didn't they? There was some city somewhere where they passed a rule. Was it Los Angeles? Someplace where they said no more high-speed chases unless they've done something. So what's your motivation to stop?
Yeah.
Well, I guess, you know, the reasoning is, well, you know, if we can identify you, we don't have to catch you right now. We can issue a warrant at large.
And that assumes the car is not stolen.
That's true.
So there's just a lot of things to consider.
Yeah, of course, safety of people driving around, too.
Yeah. All right. You want to do news?
Sure. Joy's got something planned for me tonight. I don't know what it is. I hate birthday. Please don't do anything on my birthday.
You know what?
I hate surprises.
That was right. You got three choices.
We might not come to work.
Well, you could do that, but it's still going to get you.
What?
No. Pick one of the three, and then your gift will be associated with that.
I sincerely hate birthday surprises.
Okay.
I hate them.
All right. Keep telling me stuff like that.
Do you remember the year that my now ex-wife threw me a surprise birthday party?
The one where you walked out of it? Oh, you didn't even come home.
No, I drove by, saw all the cars, kept driving. I had told her, don't throw me no parties. My 30th birthday party. And I saw all the cars, and I just kept driving.
She went to all that trouble to throw you a surprise 30th birthday party, and you just drove past?
Uh-huh. It wasn't your friend's fault.
No, I know. I drove back later. I was just pissed
off. You drove back after the party?
I came back about an hour later.
That ain't the original story you told.
I think that's the way it is. That was my drinking days. I don't remember how long I sat at the Arby's.
Is that where you went?
Yeah, parked at the Arby's.
What's your version?
I don't like surprises. I don't like, you know, birthdays are okay, but I'm not a big fan, especially mine.
You'd rather go eat potato cakes.
Pretty much. It was an Arby melt.
Oh.
You're ridiculous.
Those are good.
Yeah.
So no surprise Monday.
Can drink Crown Royal.
Do you want some?
Those are my Crown days.
This is.
I don't want any. No, I'm.
This is a special reserve they sent.
I know.
Can I just smell it again?
Sure.
It's very tasty.
I know.
Did you hear I try?
Huh?
Yeah.
That used to be my weakness. That's my heroin.
I smelled it. I don't even drink, and it smells really, really good.
Yeah.
I don't see how you can resist, JD.
God, man, that's tough. Take that away from me. Take it away
from
me.
Now you hang on to that.
I don't want it.
Why don't you wear it around your neck?
I don't want it. Hang it over there. It's delicious. I just got a lot of, you know, with a certain liquor.
Happy memories.
Yeah, I really do.
That's what it's got associated with it. That's happy times in a bottle. Have some.
I don't want any.
Can you see the label okay from where you are?
I'm just doing great. God, I used to have so many of those bags.
Waft it towards you, man.
Don't. Here. Please, why are you doing that?
Have some whiskey air.
All right, so your three choices are electricity, fire, or water.
Like, let's make a deal.
Yeah.
I don't want any of those.
I wouldn't either. But your gift is going to be associated with one of those three, depending on what you pick. Electricity, fire, or water.
Well,
I'd stay away from electricity.
Yeah, I'm going to mark that one off the list first.
Yeah,
no positives.
Nothing could happen with water.
Well, I can swim for the most part.
Okay.
Fire. I'll go between fire and water.
Up to you.
Can I tell you a little bit?
Sure.
Have a drink. It'll help you decide.
Don't help. You people should be in my group. Thanks for helping.
Have some of this.
I just want to smell it again.
Here. It's fire, water.
Take it. Fire or water? Whew, that smells good. Take it back. All right.
Hang on.
I actually salivated when I saw him do that. See, when you do Jack, it doesn't do anything for me. What cruel.
Massaging your throat as it goes down.
See, you know, vodka doesn't have any memories either because it was just, it didn't have any real aroma. But Crown.
It's fantastic.
Everett, you don't drink either. Why are you doing this?
I don't know. It's fun.
All right. But anyway, she's got something planned for me tonight. So
why is it tonight?
It's tonight and then tomorrow night we're going out to dinner.
Okay.
And then to a hotel.
Where are you going?
Rob got me the
presidential suite.
How'd you know?
Who got it?
Rob.
All right.
Don't do anything at the hotel. Now I won't enjoy the weekend at all. God, it's not like I'm not sleeping enough as it is. I lay in bed all night going, did you hear that? Did you hear that? That was the bellboy. Don't. What are you doing to me? Why do you torture me every year? You know I hate birthdays. Can we just let it go, please? Let's just have a regular show. Monday.
Up until a certain point. Electricity,
fire, or water? I choose.
Are you sure?
No.
Be certain once you say it.
Why is this funny to everybody? It's a birthday. It's supposed to be a celebration, a time of happiness.
It will be.
It's not. This is torture every freaking year.
Why was it torture last year?
Because I didn't know what was coming.
That's what makes it a surprise.
I don't like surprises. I don't like torture.
You're getting a gift.
No, yeah, but you know gifts around here. Most of them explode.
Yeah, we get the loudest gifts. Any year that you've gotten anything from us, has anything ever gone off?
Nothing's ever gone off.
Always been nice gifts?
Yes.
Sometimes you get gifts, you didn't even do anything. No birthday, no nothing. Sometimes you just get a gift for being my buddy.
I know. Those are the ones I like because this now I have an anticipation all the way to Monday of what this is going to be. Now, there's nothing good to come of electricity, fire, or water.
Okay.
I choose one.
once you say it, it's out.
I choose water.
Okay.
God, was that the wrong one? Let me re-choose. No, you're smiling because that's the wrong one.
I smile on either one, any of them.
All of them are bad. Damn. You get more creative in your torture every year.
Water it is.
Okay. I choose water.
Be your best birthday.
I'm not excited. I don't like surprises.
I don't know what the...
I don't even want to go home tonight. I don't know what Joey's got planned.
Did something bad happen to you as a kid with a surprise?
No, I just don't know. My mom always had great... I always had great birthdays. I got to eat whatever I wanted, lobster and artichoke normally.
When you were a kid?
Yeah.
He's told us this before.
Every year my birthday.
That was his big thing. He always got lobster for his birthday.
Well, you got to choose whatever you wanted to eat. It was your birthday, and I loved lobsters.
How did you get into lobster?
Well, my mother would serve it occasionally, and I loved it. It was delicious. So I always had lobster and an artichoke.
Okay. What kind of gifts did you get growing up in your affluent neighborhood?
It was back then.
All right. What'd you get?
What
were some of the gifts you got?
Just normal stuff. Bicycles and...
What kind of bicycles?
Schwinn.
Of course.
10-speed.
Have to.
Well,
obviously, you're in a hurry. Very important, child.
No, you know, Red Flyer wagons and just the regular stuff. Just regular, you know, games and nothing spectacular.
What about the glider?
That wasn't a gift. My father took me out because I wanted to be a pilot. So he took me out to learn
glider when I was 14. Nothing spectacular. You mean nothing spectacular to you because your level of expectation is different than ours.
No, just normal kid gifts. So what did you get on your 10th birthday?
Stabbed. No.
I don't remember what I got. Gifts. Army tents. Trampoline 1 year.
Those are really expensive.
The trampoline was a nice precursor.
For what?
Banging your neighbor.
Yeah, I've always loved trampolines.
Yeah.
Always. That's one thing about my house now that I don't like. The only thing I don't like about it, the backyard's not big enough for a trampoline. I really want one.
Fill in the pool?
No.
All right.
I like the pool.
All right. You ready? Wish a lifetime?
Barely.
Heavy day?
What's the water? Just tell me what it is. Give me a hint. Look at my hands. I'm sweating.
That clear stuff you can't breathe.
I know, but what are you going to do?
You can't do it to me.
Just give me a hint. Do I need to wear anything special?
Won't matter.
Gills.
No.
No.
That won't help. Anyway. I just wish Joy wouldn't do anything.
Why do you... You know she's not going to do anything to you.
She's not doing anything bad. I just don't like surprises.
Is it the attention? You just don't like people paying attention to you?
Yeah, kind of, sort of. I just want to let it go.
Is it the anxiety of not knowing?
Yeah.
That doesn't make any sense. Well, something cool's coming. Nothing bad's going to happen the majority of the time. And why is it you just can't get into it?
I just don't... I ever tried it. I don't like the attention. I don't like to be the center of attention.
Well, Monday there'll be no getting around it.
Cough developing.
We can move it.
I'll just take it.
It doesn't have to happen here.
I'll take it. You'll have to find me. Don't look in Windstar Casino, by the way.
Are you going there this weekend?
No. I might. I might Sunday.
Is that the one in Oklahoma?
Oklahoma, right over the border, yeah. Not on Sunday.
When are you going to be there?
Probably Sunday around noon. Yeah. 1 o'clock, so only an hour up there.
Okay.
What?
Nothing. Just planning out my weekend.
What can you do to me? That's another state, and that's a casino.
How about that?
You ass. Will I be able to enjoy one moment of my birthday weekend?
Yeah. We're your friends.
Okay.
Hold on a second. What is the IM you sent me, Dan? About Magoo?
Oh, I had a couple inside sources over at ZPS. They had said that no one over there can stand him, that he's just a complete dip. And...
More? Yeah.
So, apparently, his wife isn't a big fan of his either.
Why is that?
It just... They've met her, and it's... She thinks he's stupid, too. Now, granted, that could have just been a fight or something. I don't know. The details were sketchy.
Mm-hmm. I need a report from McKinney, see what's going on with this broadcast.
All right.
If anybody calls in, let me know.
Will do.
All right, we'll be back.
We'll be back to the Russ Martin Show. To the Russ Martin Show.
What does he want?
He wants quotes for the billboards they're going to put up. Quotes like, you know, fat women don't deserve sex, Russ Martin.
Oh.
Things like that. We had a list of them before, and I don't know what he's done with it, but he wants a quote for the billboard.
What are these going on?
You wouldn't talk to him in the hall.
I'm not talking to him.
He stopped me in the bathroom. I wasn't going to talk to him either, but he had me in the bathroom.
You guys do whatever you want. You never listen to me anyway.
I will if he tells not to.
Not once have you ever hated the same person I do.
I certainly do.
When do they need these?
We both hate the Magoo.
Yeah, I suppose.
Along with his wife. They need them ASAP. They're going to put the billboards up pretty soon. Like he wants them like Monday.
My boss sits to pee.
No, don't do that. No. No.
Give me a pen clip.
Don't write these down. He's not going to produce these.
Everett. Yes?
Oh. Any ideas?
Another quote.
My boss got mouth effed by a chihuahua.
Yeah. I'm just going to change it from my boss to Gavin. No reason to let him slip through the anonymity hole. Gavin got it in the mouth. From a chihuahua.
And he can't see you because it happened.
Yeah. Anyone else?
Gavin's not only a member, he's also the president.
Nobody will get that.
It's off topic.
Unless you put it at the top, the vagina club.
God.
Like in an organization, you have to join, like MW. Let's see. Yeah, MWV, and with vaginas.
No.
And then you can put that quote.
Right.
What, Dan?
I was going to say, you just you do some quote from the vagina monologues and just attribute it to Gavin.
There's always the wipes front to back.
Yeah, that's the other one I was going to throw out.
Gavin wipes front to back?
Mm-hmm.
Because he got sick when he did it the other way.
Yeah, got an infection.
Oh, okay. How long are these boards? How many boards are we getting?
I don't know. Probably 10, 15.
Where are they going to put them?
They said they're really good locations, like I-30, I-20, 635.
Are they full-size boards full or size, those gammy ones that they normally put malt liquor on?
No, big boards. Yeah. Full-size big boards. And it's just dedicated to your show.
Gavin knows how you taste. Something along those lines.
The Russ Martin Show tastes great. Gavin Spittle.
Yeah.
Something like that. Great taste.
Less filling. Yeah. Okay.
got my sack itches.
The itching's nice.
Okay.
What about those liners that we did for him a while back, like he colors with his own grunt?
Yeah. Grunt liner.
Two chromosomes.
Yeah. There, that's plenty.
Okay. We'll rotate those around.
Is that what they're going to do?
Huh?
Are these free boards? Are these boards that Infinity owns?
No. They're actually spending money on this time. Because they finally got money from corporate for the big free FM push. And they're going to highlight
five years that we've been here, and all of a sudden they decide to cough up cash for a billboard campaign.
They finally decided that this format's going to work.
That Russ Martin Show might take off if we push it.
And the high priority personalities in every market are going to get billboards. Like in Chicago, it'll be Steve Dahl and Kenny. What is his name? David Lee Roth.
All right. Hold on. Hi, Troy.
How you doing, Russ?
Good.
I'm up here at the Hooters in McKinney, and this Magoo guy, he is driving me nuts.
What is he doing?
He's talking. As long as he's playing music, he's okay, but as long as he's talking, it sucks. He hasn't said anything about the Russmeister, so I don't know.
Does he look rattled at all, or does he just look like he kind of blew it off?
Well, actually, he walked over, he talked to some of his little... fat, chubby, little bodyguard-looking dudes, and now he's surrounded at a table.
With his bodyguards?
Not really bodyguards. I'd call them, like, little fat, chubby guys.
Promotion people.
Oh, okay.
She's got you hooked up right there, buddy.
All right, let me know if something happens.
I will. You right. Sending some people up?
John Powell.
Yeah.
Is your mic?
Okay.
Thank you. Where's the two-way? What he said when Rob told him that we were coming. Rob? What did Magoo say when you told him we were coming?
Okay, why don't you guys come on out?
I guess he's ready.
Play tough guy.
All right.
See how that works out.
All right, let's try news now.
Okay.
Did you do a legal ID, Clo?
Yes.
Do we know what time Defiled is coming in?
I don't know. Dan?
Rob?
Somebody said 6 o'clock, I think.
Six.
Is it 6?
Yeah, we had told them after 6 o'clock. depending on, I guess, the dart.
Their tour bus. You weren't here when they called, Trey. The what was her name? Cheryl?
Yeah, Cheryl.
She called at the start of the show. Wanted to come up and play. Said, all right, when do you guys want to come up? Well, we figure it's going to take two buses to get there. I didn't get it at first. Then that's when we said maybe you should change your band's name to Dart.
They're huge.
Yeah.
That'd be good.
How does she sound on the phone?
She sounded more normal than I thought she would. I still haven't met anybody in the building that's seen them. Except Rob. And he's not saying a whole lot. Just said that they look unique.
This would be fun.
Mm. They've got a full album.
The six songs a full album?
Well, yeah, more or less. You know, I guess more of an EP, I guess.
Okay. All right, are you ready?
Yep.
Okay, here we go. Did you say you did legal or not?
Yes.
Yes? All right. 503, J.D. Ryan's here with news.
Thank you, Russ. Friday, November the 11th, 2005. Leonardo DiCaprio is 31 today. Demi Moore turns 43. Over the weekend, Tanya Harding, still around. She'll be 35. Sammy Sosa, 37. Neil Young is 60 on Saturday. Al Michaels, 61. Charles Manson, 71. And on Sunday, Jimmy Kimmel turns 38. Vinny Testaverde will be 42. Whoopi Goldberg will be 50. Wednesday, executives from the five major oil companies sat in front of the Senate and swore. They swore there had been no gasoline price gouging, and they said they actually earned their $33 billion total profits between July and September. Their yearly profit is supposed to be more than double what it was two years ago, they say. But Lee Raymond, the chairman of the ExxonMobil folks, says that their profit margins are within line of other industries.
All right. Well, they're claiming that capitalism works.
Yes.
That's their defense on... Actually, all of this.
Well, what they're claiming, and this is somewhat true, is that...
Why is it you're always on their side?
Sort of a capitalist, I mean. But what they're saying is that oil is a cyclical time. I mean, 5 years ago, oil was trading at $8 to $10 a barrel, and they were all losing.
5 years ago, was it $8 to $10 a barrel?
Yeah.
Oil.
That sounds awfully cheap.
That was damn cheap.
Well, I mean, compared to what a barrel of oil
is. I didn't think oil had been $8 to $10 a barrel since the 70s.
No. I mean, there were a lot of people who had to literally just shut their pumps off.
Why was gas so much?
Gas, if you remember, there was a point where we were paying like $1.10. This was like 5 years ago. And then
is that what it was?
Yeah.
Yeah, but it doesn't seem like the math adds up. You know, if we're paying $60 a barrel as compared to 8 or 10, you know, that's six times. As compared to gas being maybe 2.5 times what it was then.
Yeah. We either were getting screwed or we're getting screwed. I can't do the math, so I don't know which, but I just know it was one end of the sandwich.
Yeah, well, you know, we have all these problems, and the hurricanes have shut everything down. Why are they having record, I mean, ridiculously record profits?
Yeah. They're more oil companies than gas companies. I mean, oil is their primary business, and when oil is trading at $65, $70 a barrel, they're raking it in. The gas going up to... I mean, I think right now, you know, even at its highest, gas on the wholesale market was trading at $1.80.
So they bumped it up artificially when the hurricanes hit. I mean, because it didn't suddenly get 80 cents more expensive to make.
Well, no, it's on the wholesale market. You still have your distributor, your gas station, and someone in between that each
somebody
take
made
a cut.
A profit.
No. Well, I'm not saying they weren't making a profit.
In 2 weeks, it didn't go up 80 cents.
And but they profited from disaster. That's what makes it even worse.
Well, no, it's a supply and demand issue. We are at 100% refining capacity. Now, when you took 15, 20% of that refining capacity off, you lost 15 to 20% of your supply. Therefore,
it's time to have people around. That's what they did. How do you defend that? They do it to us all the time. Cut us some slack during a disaster. I think that's basically what's coming out of people's mouths.
Well, what they're saying now is, yeah, all right, you've made record profits. But what they want the oil companies to do is instead of just...
They want the windfall?
Is start investing in new refineries. Stuff where we don't go through this again. So, you know.
We don't go through what? Record profits? Yeah, we wouldn't want to do that.
Well.
Mobil Exxon?
We shouldn't.
I think he's talking about if another natural disaster happens.
Yeah, we don't go through this.
We're not screwed because we don't have refineries to refine the oil that we got. We got oil, we just can't get anybody to turn it into gas. Is that it?
Yes.
Okay. So but obviously, Congress thinks something screwy's going on, mm-hmm. or they wouldn't be having these hearings.
Congress likes to posture for the camera.
Okay. But they still have to have some kind of reason to do this.
No, they don't. I
mean, hold on a second.
They had baseball hearings.
There's a fan of yours on the phone. Go ahead, Roy.
Yeah, Trey's an idiot.
All right.
See?
Keep going.
Congress holds hearings for everything. I mean, that's if they can get in the camera and be on camera and look like they're fighting for their constituents, that's what they do.
But this is not Rafael Palmero. This is money. We all saw the price go up in 2 days to ridiculous prices, and it suddenly came back down.
What was gas before the hurricane? I don't even have a point of reference because I got excited.
Is that where it is now?
Really?
220.
I saw it last night for 216, and I actually stopped just seeing if I had some empty pockets.
Investment time.
Yeah.
I want to buy some and put it away.
Because I had just gotten gas.
On my pull up.
So that's about where it was.
Actually, it's a little bit lower.
It's changed so fast, I couldn't remember where it was and how long it was, wherever it was.
Yeah, it wasn't
about. Oil's also gone down about $10 a barrel in the last couple months.
So what are we at now, 59?
57. I think it was close, like 57, 50, somewhere around there.
I'm still with Everett on this. If the price of oil, if a barrel's about $55, $57, how come gas is only a couple of dollars? Where back in the 80s, if it was $8 to $12, a gallon of gas is like $1.10.
Well, because
right?
Yeah, exactly.
Something.
There are fixed costs associated with refining the gasoline.
All right, hold on a second. Yes, Roy?
Yeah, Trey's an idiot.
All right, go ahead.
So.
Try to defend that.
He got me.
I don't have. I couldn't explain any of it, so I'm just going to sit and listen. Go ahead.
No, I mean, there are fixed costs associated with gas. I mean, so
it can only be so cheap.
Yeah.
Well, just like anything else, everything has a fixed cost.
It's just awful, damn weird. The year we have two major hurricanes, disasters, and crises.
Well, that's
gas shoots up, and then they still make a big profit. That they should have taken a hit, like the airlines did.
Well, hang on, but their profits are before third quarter last year. Oh. Not just a quarter ago. So always keep that in mind when they say up 30%.
So we might see them take a hit in the next quarter.
Not with oil trading. I mean, they're still making a lot of money.
They're never going to take a hit.
Oh, all these companies were losing their ass like 5-6 years ago when oil was so cheap.
I don't remember that.
Yeah.
I remember it being about $1.10, but I didn't.
I don't even remember that.
I didn't follow the price of it.
I don't have any recollection of gas being cheaper than $2.
Oh, if you went out to West Texas.
Like, I mean, except for, you know, when I was in college or whatever, but I mean, in recent memory, I couldn't. If I had to come up with a price of what it was before Rita or
Katrina,
I have a clue. I totally lost track.
Yeah.
I think most people
because it was
did.
No big deal. You monitored every single day and watch it go up and watch them literally walk out, change the number, go back in, come back out, change the number.
Yeah. Gas would change while we're on the air.
Absolutely.
Or the price.
By 10 cents.
And I think Trey's in with them.
He's always on their side. You got, do you have oil stock?
Mm-mm.
Do you have oil stock?
Mm-mm.
You have gas stock?
No.
What do you got?
I don't have anything.
You got something?
They're making money. I mean, there's no doubt about it. And are they gouging people somewhat? Yes. Should they, you know, knock it off? Yeah. But I also, they're in the business to make money. They're not in it for...
Okay, and that's fine. I think people recognize that. It's just during a natural disaster, how about you cut us some slack? I think that's the... Hold on a second. Yes, Roy?
Who is this? I lost Roy.
Well, it's kind of like selling life preservers on a sinking ship. Yeah, you can do it, but I mean...
Yeah, because all of a sudden the demand just went up,
right.
And you only have so many. That's kind of what it is. They didn't seem to bother them.
Very much what it is.
What about that?
Well, how come TXU just can't come around and go, you know what? We feel like electricity had to double.
Because they're regulated.
They're regulated, so the gas and oil companies aren't. Mm-hmm.
It's a commodity. And commodity can trade for whatever they want. For what? That's, you know what? This isn't our own fault. And I keep saying this, and for some reason it doesn't seem to stick. The demand is there because we're buying it.
Sure.
We're buying cars the size of tanks They get rotten gas mileage, and we're pissed off because they got us under their thumb. Right. And it's going to be that way until we do something.
We're not going to ever do anything.
Not now. You know why? Because gas just went back down, and the big thrust to do the refineries or buy cars that get good gas mileage, that's going to fade out, and it's going to fade out quick.
And they know that.
And here's the problem. I mean, you know, people are absolutely bitching and moaning about gas prices, but you take a poll. I mean, like they did it in California at these prices. Would you okay putting a refinery in California? It was like 70% said no. So, you know, you can bitch about the prices, but there's the simple solution to do something about it. Is
why don't they want a refinery in California?
Refineries are just messy.
Okay.
The environment.
Where are they now? Are they mostly in East Texas, West Texas?
Texas City.
Gulf, where is that?
Gulf Coast. Yeah. Down here.
Oh, okay. Louisiana.
Louisiana. Places we don't care about.
Hold on a second.
It's going to be crappy anyway.
Who cares? We've got oil on it. It's a turd. Now you got a shiny turd.
It's worth something.
Yeah. Yeah. We just gave you a turd of value.
Yeah.
You're welcome. Yes, Daniel?
Yeah, Trey's an idiot.
All right.
Their legions grow.
Yeah.
Write that down for one of the billboards. These will probably come in the course of a week. We'll get some real ones that they can use.
Okay.
Hold on. Go ahead, Greg.
Hey, listen, there's Trey's an idiot. No, I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding.
Go ahead.
He's oversimplifying it. There's a number of different...
Well, he knows he's got to do that with me, because if he goes beyond what he just told me, I'm out.
Well, it's just oversimplification, because there's a number of different components to oil prices. There's the oil company, the refiners, the distributors, and then there's traders. Trading goes on all day long for the oil prices, and it depends on when the distributor buys the price of oil, when they purchase the oil. That's what determines the price at the pump, because they don't purchase, you know, 5 or 10 barrels. They purchase, you know, 500,000 barrels, and each barrel has 55 gallons in it. And so they sell it at that price. And when oil refining is down, when the production is down at the refineries, then it's passed on at the pump because they've already purchased it at a higher price.
Anybody got that?
No.
That's why you ain't here. What'd he say?
Basically, what I'm talking about is it's a supply and demand issue, and when the refining capacity went down, gasoline, like a lot of it, is traded on the open market, and when, even before,
I know,
when the hurricane was on its way,
here's
it started going
the, here's
up.
The easiest way to look at it. It's like Cabbage Patch Dolls.
Huh?
What? There was a limited supply.
Oh.
You couldn't get them. People would pay anything that they, that you would ask for one of those things.
That's true. Because everybody wanted one.
And you had to have one, and they weren't pumping that many out.
That's true.
That's the easiest way I can look at it. Is that close?
It's a very good analogy.
Thank you.
So they're Cabbage Patch gouginess.
Mm-hmm.
They're Cabbage Patchness.
Yeah, they're getting this right in the patch.
And there's nobody anywhere that can slap the oil companies around and go, hey.
I think Congress is well, I think that's the reason for the hearings.
We're watching you.
Well, what was the windfall thing they were talking about? Windfall profit tax?
Yeah.
They bring that up?
I'm sorry.
The windfall the Congress brought up to the oil companies.
Oh, yeah. Right. They want to know, what are you doing with all the money you're making?
Spending. I didn't know if they were going to tax it.
Oh, they're taxing it as much as they possibly can.
I didn't know if they were going to slap more on it. But they make sense. Go build more refineries. That's what got us into this. That's the issue. We got oil. We can't do nothing with it.
Well, the Saudis said a long time ago, they said, we'll ship you, you know, a million more barrels a day. You can't do anything with it. And that's...
Do they have refineries?
Saudis?
Yeah.
Sure.
Okay. Why can't we get gas?
Part of the reason is really... The funny thing is Saudi oil really isn't that great.
Oh.
They have... I think it's called dark bitter crude. Or dark sour
crude. As opposed to sweet light?
Light sweet crude.
Yeah. Right. You don't want your car getting bitter oil.
Well, it's a grill.
Grill. Go ahead, Trey.
It's just harder to refine.
Oh. So they can't do it?
You know, I'm now getting out of my realm of knowledge.
All right. It's okay, because I stopped understanding about 12 minutes ago.
All right. Well, the city of Irving is starting to get tough with the Dallas Cowboys management over the deteriorating condition of Texas Stadium.
I heard about this.
The city wants to make sure the Cowboys leave the stadium in tip-top shape before they switch over to Arlington in 2009. So the city council members, who recently started looking at the fine print of their lease, they've come up with the fact that basically the lease says, you give us the stadium back in the same condition we gave it to you, which means you fix everything.
And well, yeah, you don't get your deposit back.
No, you never did.
we had to replace the turf and the pads underneath it.
They did. Just to paint the roof is going to be $570,000. That's just to paint it, not to fix all the other problems that it has. So the Cowboys are going, mm-mm. You know, they'll find all kinds of ways. They'll find a way that Irving didn't live up to their end of it. And they'll go, you broke the contract. Not us.
There's a breach here.
You know they will.
Sure.
If it's Jerry Jones and a couple of $1 million,
right?
Get out of my way.
Well, but if the Cowboys don't do it, nobody, hold on. What is it, Rob?
Hey, I just want to let you know the ladies from Defile are here. I'm going to just put them back in the green room.
Where's the green room now that all the offices are torn up? Put them in Gavin's office.
Okay.
Hey, are you walking by the window right now?
No, I'm back at the green room.
Where is that?
That's the kitchen.
Oh. Walk them by the window so we can see what they look like.
Shades.
Huh? We'll just...
All right, hold on one second.
Are you coming now? All right, tell me as soon as you're walking them down the hall. And then we'll just, don't open the blinds, we'll just peek at it.
Peek through. Bunch of grown men peek out.
I gotta see what they look like now.
Okay.
I'm just gonna wait, I don't wanna miss it.
Okay. I'll put my stuff down.
What's line 9?
Yeah, line 9. They were hanging out with Magoo.
No. All right, Scott, make it quick.
Hey, what's going on? We stopped at the Walmart in Allen and got us some white T-shirts. But,
all right, hang on a second. Are you coming? Are you coming?
Yeah.
Oh, I see.
I missed it. Did you ever see, what's the movie, Toxic Avenger?
Yeah.
Really? You don't see him again?
Yeah.
All right. Hey, Rob.
Yeah.
Can you walk him back by?
All right. They're starting to ask questions.
Well, just tell him you're airing them out. Can you walk him back by now?
Look at the windowsill.
That Toxic Avenger might have been a compliment.
A couple of Yetis with guitars.
All right. Let's be nice to the guests.
They're getting free radio.
I know.
We're plugging the band. What, Dan?
Can we ask them or ask Rob to ask them if they crossed the highway or something like that to get here? Someone called in about 10 minutes ago and said he saw two chicks crossing 183, and he said it has to be them. I thought there's no way because I
couldn't have been because
bus.
Yeah, they got equipment. Rob, how did they get here?
By bus.
Do they have to cross the highway at any point for any reason, like to change buses?
I don't know. They might have.
Oh. Hey, could you run down to CVS and get us a bunch of radiation suits?
You want a break? Yeah.
Nice clothes.
We'll be back to
to the Russ Martin Show. DFW's dominating afternoon force. The Russ Martin Show.